licensed mental health counselor through the state of Massachusetts, and I'm fortunate enough to have the opportunity to work over at the North Reading Police Station as North Reading's mental health and substance abuse clinician. I'm here with...
I'm Jami Racioppi. I'm a North Reading resident, and I was a youth cheerleading coach here in North Reading for 5 years. I'm here today to talk about a youth group that faces healthcare disparities. I am also a nurse. I've been a nurse for 24 years, and I'm working on furthering my education, and that's why I actually focused on this project.
Wonderful. So Jami did a project in furthering her education on the LGBTQ plus youth community, and we got in contact. She was able to share her presentation with the community impact team, and we're fortunate to have you here today to kind of review the presentation. We wanted to be able to get the presentation to North Reading families so they can watch it in the comfort of their own home, at their own time, at their own speed, and get the information that's so important for families to have. So thank you, Jami, for being here. We have a few questions for you if you'd like to review your presentation. So just the basics from the start. We hear these acronyms such as LGBTQ and LGBTQ+.
Yes.
Can you share with me what they stand for?
I can. So LGBTQQIAAP. It's a lot of alphabetical letters, very important. Lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, transsexual, queer, questioning, intersex, asexual, ally, pansexual. Most people use LGBT or LGBTQ. That is appropriate and acceptable within the gay community to shorten it down to that. They stand for lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, or queer.
Okay. And the plus signifies the longer acronym that you had mentioned. Wonderful. Thank you. So when you were researching this topic, I'm sure you came across, or you let me know you came across, certain risks or disparities that the population can face.
I did.
Unfortunately.
Right.
Can you share some with us?
Sure. So I'd like to point out that first, the stress associated with negative LGBT experiences often places the LGBTQ young folks at risk for these negative health outcomes and inequitable experiences. Some of the disparities include lack of provider understanding, embarrassment about LGBT status, societal stigma, denial of civil and human rights, such as same-sex marriage or refusal of health insurance coverage, employment and educational discrimination. In addition, the transgender youth group faces the highest disparity when trying to seek out behavioral health services.
Wow.
And then, in addition to that, the increased rates of anxiety and depression are a result of discrimination, isolation, and bullying. And it makes the LGBTQ community at increased risk for sexually transmitted diseases, depression, suicide, substance abuse, relational violence, low self-esteem, and body image disorder. And LGBTQ violence is actually the second largest hate crime behind race-based violence.
Oh my goodness, what an awful statistic to share. And, you know, it is such a vulnerable population to begin with, our youth. You know, they're the future adults of our community. So they're so young and so impressionable. To face these disparities is just terrible. Thank you for sharing that with us. I know you came across some pretty staggering statistics in your research, one of which you just shared with us. Did you come across anything else that you found to be shocking?
Yes, I did. I'd like to point out that being part of the LGBT community is not the cause of these challenges.
Absolutely.
It's actually the rather high rates that many face is due to the bias and discrimination, also due to family rejection and other stressors because of their sexual identity or gender identity. But some of those statistics, for instance, the unfortunate statistics, LGBTQ youth are more likely to attempt suicide than their peers, with a rate of 18% to 43% when compared to 9% to 13% of their heterosexual peers.
Wow.
So approximately 13 to 17 identified approximately 1 in 4 LGBT youth ages 13 to 17 identified non-accepting families as the most important challenge in their lives. So it actually, the acceptance of families increases their health outcome.
Isn't that amazing?
Mentally and physically, wow. Their health outcome improves. And in addition, transgender youth have the highest rates for developing substance abuse issues. Mm-hmm. But there is one good statistic.
Okay, give it to us.
Some good news is that Boston is ranked 22nd, the 22nd highest city in the country is having the largest gay population. So we do have an area right. where everyone can fit in.
Awesome, so, awesome. And it right. just speaks to the impression that you can have on others or the impact you can have on others. Acceptance matters and can make a big difference. Mm-hmm. So thank you for ending on a positive yes. note there. So to take that one step further, what can we do so we have an impact on others? What can mm-hmm. we do to support people who are either transitioning or coming out with their identity, mm-hmm. sharing this experience with people that they care about? How can we support our loved ones who have shared this identity mm-hmm. with us?
So research demonstrates that the support between family and LGBT youth and just the community
yep.
actually increases the physical and mental health outcomes, such as what we just talked about. It's really important that if somebody is opening up to you, it means they trust you. Mm-hmm. It's important that we listen carefully and that we are not belittling or humiliating about their honesty, even if we're not in agreement.
Absolutely.
As hard as that might be, we have mm-hmm. to put our own feelings aside and just listen. We need to show interest and seek out resources to help ourselves and help our loved one. And this knowledge is power. So those are some of the things. In addition, we need to let that young person know that they'll have a happy adult life mm-hmm. identifying with an LGBTQ. Transgender is really hard, but even that person will still have a happy life with the proper support, and we need to let them know that. We need to advocate. That's a big one. And that's what we're doing yes. here today. So we need to advocate if they're mistreated because of their identity. It's important that we don't block access. Mm-hmm. So if somebody's opening up to their loved one, we don't want to block access to friends or events or resources within the LGBT community, thinking that we can stop this yes. from yep. happening, or blame them when they're discriminated against, or pressure someone to be less masculine or less feminine
okay.
and try to pull them away from something they identify with. So
wonderful. What helpful do's and don'ts? You had mentioned seeking out resources.
Yes.
Do you know of community resources that can be beneficial to this community?
Mm-hmm. Yes, there's some actual fabulous ones. We're very fortunate that way. There's Bagley, which is the Boston Youth Group, and there's NAGLE, it's the North Shore Support Group. Both have testimonials on their website. They're local support groups, and it's for parents and for youth.
Wonderful.
And they can attend together, and I suggest that anybody who's can identify with these challenges that they check those sites out. I think that these would really help. There's also Fenway Health in Boston. That's that gears their care towards the LGBT community. And then Healthy People 2020, that's actually a data collection system within the government, and they're looking to eliminate these health disparities.
Wonderful. So people can mm-hmm. just go online and search these, is it agencies or websites, and get more information?
So some are agencies, all are websites,
okay.
and they can just get all the information they need at the click of a finger.
Perfect.
So, mm-hmm.
Easy access. We'll mm-hmm. take it. So it's my understanding that it is normal for this to be a stressful time mm-hmm. when people are coming forward with their identity. They may have felt this way for years and years, and they're just bringing it to the forefront and sharing it with people they care about. Do you have any words for somebody who might feel like it won't get any better?
I do. It will get better. They're not alone. And 77% of youth members that identify as LGBTQ have actually statistically reported they know it will get better.
How wonderful is that?
Yeah.
We'll take it.
Yeah.
77%, that's a beautiful number.
That is.
We hope one day by doing things like this we can yeah. raise that to 100, but we'll take 77 for mm-hmm. now. Jami, thank you so much for being here today and giving this information to the community. It's really important, and we're happy to have you here in North Reading.
Thank you, Laura.
Of course. If you have any more information on how to get you or your loved one help, I can be reached here in town at 978-357-5038 or just by popping over to the police station. Thank you.